much.
Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Assalamu alaikum. Please, I request all to be seated on your chairs. We will start with the today's session. And I must say good morning to all. I am Dr. Asif Sawai.
Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Assalamu alaikum.
Please, I request all. So I am Dr. Asma Shawani, Assistant Professor, Lajgambad Institute of Medical Sciences, on the behalf of Pakistan Society of Hepatology as a regional representative from the Sindh. I welcome you all for this 22nd annual Congress meeting of the PSH. Here in beautiful historical city of the Lahore. I am a moderator for your session debate day 2 on defining and the management of the acute and chronic liver failure, east versus the west. So before starting with the introduction of our respective chairperson, I would like to I must say there is a QR. So QR code, there is an important announcement regarding the QR code. You can see a QR code displayed on your tables. You can get attached and stay tuned with us throughout the session. So it's a debatable session. There will be the pre-polling and the post-polling session as well. So I must request all the audience, respected doctors, to be seated, so that we may start our session in proper time and end it. So we can start, Dr. So let me introduce and invite the respected chairperson. I would like to invite Dr. Mozam to have a seat on the stage. He is a gastroenterologist, focal person, Prime Minister, NCM Hepatitis Control Program, ex-president of Pakistan Society of Gastroenterology, 2008 to 2010. He has achieved lifetime achieving award of Pakistan Society of Gastroenterology in 2008. He is a founding member of the PSH and president of PSH 2018 to 2019. And he has achieved lifetime achievement award of PSH 2019 as well. Welcome, sir. Now I may request Professor Naseebullah Shah Saab to have a seat on the stage. He is an ex-professor of medicine, Sandiman Provincial Hospital, Quetta. Now he is a director, quality assurance, Bolan University Medical Health Sciences, executive member of the Pakistan Society of Gastroenterology. He is a focal person and executive member of PSH from Balochistan. Thank you, sir, to be here. Now I'm moving to my third chairperson, that is Dr. Shamzeri. He is associate professor, hepatobiliary pancreatic liver transplant surgeon at Gumbert Institute of Medical Sciences. He has experience of more than 700 liver transplant in country. Recently he has been awarded as a fellow of American College of the Surgery. Dr. Shams has remarkable contribution in expansion of liver transplant centers in Pakistan, likewise in Qadiazm International Hospital, Islamabad, and Ziauddin Hospital, Karachi. So I'm coming to the important topic in the field of hepatology, that is defining and management of acute and chronic liver failure. It's always era of the great interest between the transplant surgeon and transplant hepatologist. So for the debate, we have a speakers, Dr. Jennifer Lai from the West UCSF. So before starting the debate, there is a rule of the debate. We must stick to the time because of we are already running short of the time. So let me introduce Dr. Jennifer Lai. She is Associate Professor of Medicine, Transplant Hepatologist, who specializes in caring of the patient from diagnosis to the liver transplant and beyond. Dr. Jennifer is a clinical investigator. She is a researcher. Our research program has been continuously supported by the numerous organizations, including National Institute of the Health, AASLD, American Gastroenterology Association, ACG, American Society of Transplantation. She has got Young Investigator Award, AGA 2020, Long-Term Mentor Award, UCSF Medical Student 2021. She is Fellow of American Society of Transplantation, and she will be having the virtual recorded presentation, and she is live with us for the debate and the any question at the end of the session. So I must request Dr. Jennifer Lai before starting this recorded virtual presentation to be with us live for the debate later on. So please kindly start the mentioned earlier that is displayed on your tables. You can get attached. Please follow this. So the aim is in your practice, do you see ACLF patient? Simple. All the audience, if connect with the Slido, you can participate with us so that we can have a post-debate presentation and the comments as well. Now we have just two participants.
I'm delighted to speak to you today on defining and managing ACLF from the perspective of the West. I'm Jennifer Lai, hepatologist at the University of California, San Francisco. Here are my financial disclosures. I'd like to start off with the case of Mr. Khan. He's a 56-year-old man with decompensated cirrhosis due to NASH who is admitted with jaundice, worsening ascites, and altered mental status requiring intubation. He is hypotensive requiring vasopressor support. His MELD score has risen from 9 4 months ago to 32 on admission, now requiring renal replacement therapy for acute kidney injury. Workup revealed spontaneous bacterial peritonitis and E. coli bacteremia. I think that we can all agree that at a minimum this patient has presented with acute hepatic decompensation. But increasingly, this clinical presentation has been recognized as a syndrome distinct from acute hepatic decompensation, one that has been termed acute on chronic liver failure. What exactly is acute on chronic liver failure? In the broadest of definitions, acute on chronic liver failure has been defined as a syndrome in patients with chronic liver disease with or without previously diagnosed cirrhosis, characterized by acute hepatic decompensation resulting in liver failure and one or more extrahepatic failures associated with increased mortality up to 3 months. Importantly, ACLF is distinguishable from the simple clinical presentation of chronic liver disease without cirrhosis, compensated cirrhosis, as well as traditional acute decompensated cirrhosis without other organ failures. Most of what we know about the clinical aspects of ACLF come from three cohorts worldwide. The Asian Pacific Association for the Study of Liver Diseases ACLF Research Consortium consists of over 5,200 patients from 43 centers in 15 countries within the Asia Pacific region. The EASL chronic liver failure cohort consists of over 1,300 patients at 29 liver units in 8 countries in Europe. And the North American Consortium for the Study of End-Stage Liver Disease consists of over 2,600 patients at 14 centers in the United States and Canada. Now, all of these cohorts consist of patients who represent the sickest of our patients with chronic liver disease. But the Eastern cohort differs from the two Western cohorts by two major factors. The first is their requirement for cirrhosis for enrollment. The APOSL definition does not require cirrhosis for ACLF diagnosis, and the APOSL cohort included patients with acute alcoholic hepatitis and acute hepatitis B reactivation without cirrhosis, whereas the Western cohorts only included patients with underlying cirrhosis. The second is the primary driver of acute injury among the patients enrolled in the cohorts, with the Eastern cohort consisting of a substantial proportion of patients with acute alcohol, acute viral hepatitis, drug-induced liver injury, and autoimmune hepatitis, whereas the Western cohorts included a substantial proportion of patients with non-liver infectious precipitants, with 40% of patients without an identifiable precipitating event. From these three cohorts, three individual clinical scoring systems have emerged, one from the East region of the world, one from Europe, and one from North America. Now, I'm not going to go into the specifics of each scoring system, but I want to provide you with a broad understanding of the key components and test characteristics of each of these scoring systems so that you can make the decision about which scoring system to use and when. The general underlying principle of each of the clinical scoring systems is that the components represent dysfunction of multiple organ systems, whether it be the liver, kidney, brain, circulatory, or respiratory systems. Let's get more specific into the key components of each prediction model so you can see where these scoring systems overlap and where they differ. Liver dysfunction is characterized by total bilirubin and coagulopathy are components of both the APOSL and EASL prediction models, but not the North American.